Kensel Culture Puppets Props Puns Podcasts.
Hey, welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to another segment of Eye on America. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is where we explore different lifestyles, different jobs, different occupations that are sometimes not within the norm. That's why we're going to put our eye right now on Mr. Hal Barris, and he is the head zookeeper at Delanco, New Jersey Zoo. And let's have a nice hand for Mr. Hal Barris. Hal! How the hell are you doing, Hal?
It's nice to be here. Put it this way, it's rainy out, but I made it here, and I was, put it this way, I was very busy at the zoo today. I was very busy.
The zoo was busy
yes.
today?
Yeah. I was circumcising different animals, and the other keepers came up to me and said, you don't work here. Put it this way, yes, I do.
You work for the tips. All right. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, right now, Hal, I have a confession to make. I have a girlfriend who works with you.
Who's this?
Oh, I have a girlfriend. She works at the Delanco Zoo, and I had a lot of girlfriends, but this one's a keeper.
Put it this way. The zoo is a very serious place. Put it this way. Hold on a second.
Hal is actually... Oh, getting a little bit of that liquid courage that you need to be around, you know.
I thought this was a two-shot.
I mean, you need a little stimulation. Did you work with tigers? I hear you identify with them. Actually, with some animals, I hear you're a cheetah.
Put it this way. Stupid kids at the zoo... We had at the kids at the zoo, they had to name the baby zebra.
Okay.
And they're very stupid, these kids. You know what they named the zebra?
I don't know what they named it. What did they name the zebra at the Delanco Zoo?
Spot. Put this one. I would name the zebra. No, I wouldn't name the zebra. I would have named the zebra.
John?
I would have named it...
Or Hal?
Put it this way.
Hal, what would you have named the zebra? Because I know that you love animals and you've been right there,
I would have named Joe Fedora. I went to school with him.
Joe Fedora? You went to school with him. Why would you name a zebra Joe Fedora?
I just dig that name. Put it this way, it's a name that's for the ages.
I thought it would be Bill Murray you would name the zebra because he was in stripes.
Put it this way. Animals don't like having names, but they should wear name tags. But speaking of animals.
Yeah, I'll speak of animals.
I've bought some animals from the zoo today.
Did you
put it this way?
Did you give the elephant anything to drink?
No, why?
Do you know why elephants drink?
Put it this way. Why do elephants drink?
To forget.
What?
They never forget, John. Hal.
I bought some creatures from the zoo. Creatures from the zoo for
what?
Us.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, he's bought a couple of creatures from the zoo that he is going to share with us.
They prefer to be called creatures, too, not animals.
Don't stick your tongue out at me.
What? Put it this way. We have here, it's a very rare Delanco beaver that I found.
Delanco? Yes. Damn.
Yes, and hold on a second. Oh, he's there. He's very lively.
What are you doing with that? Oh, okay.
This one has been being treated because his previous owners left him in their house while The View was on TV.
How could he stand such torture? And look at the, you know, and I hear he had dental work done.
Yeah, he did. His teeth are new.
Oh, I thought that he bought them. How much did that cost?
A buck. Put it this way.
So they're buck teeth.
Yes. He's a very good animal here, too. And a
wonderful animal. Okay. Very industrious. Okay. Eager beaver. Yes.
And beavers taste like a Baconator.
You've eaten beaver?
Yes. Put it this way, this shows G.
A guy like you, I don't even think he ever saw a beaver.
Put it this way, put it this way.
Yeah.
This next animal here is a. That was the last. No, we don't want to talk
that
about
came,
that.
That came. That we found that in the lion cage.
Oh. Well, this one here, this is a unique animal. Would you want to see, here? I can hold this one.
Wow. That's a polecat right there.
Yeah. No, it's. Here, can you explain? I'll let you. Is it your favorite animal?
Well, if this was smell-o-vision, yeah. Okay. I hear that Disney's making a new movie about a skunk.
Yeah, what's it called?
Stinkerbell.
Put it this way. What do you know about skunks? What do you know? Put it this way.
Well, we're going to have to draw the line right here. I know that this makes sense, okay? And right here, and this makes even less sense, doesn't it?
How do you know that?
How do I know that? Instinct.
Put it this way.
How do you stop a skunk from smelling?
Put it this way. This skunk just gave birth and would return the skunk baby to its womb. Put it this way.
Okay.
And now, this is the most rarest animal.
Rarest animal in the entire Delco Zoo.
At the Delanco Zoo. Delanco Zoo.
Delanco Zoo. Yes, Hal. Hal!
It's a very... Hold on a second. He had a tag stuck on his toe.
What the hell?
Now, this here is a rare Bolivian vampire hamster right there. Right there.
A vampire hamster? Vampire,
yes. And they're noted. They live in trees, and they build fires. They go to the mall. Several practice... Yeah. Judaism, and they're very wonderful animals here,
stop that!
It just bit me. The Bolivian vampire hamster just bit me.
Oh no, he's going to turn into a Bolivian hamster. Wasn't there some?
I don't feel so good. I'll be right back. I have to go to the bathroom.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We had to interrupt our program, Eye on America, because of a tragic event, okay? Our guest, Mr. Hal Barris, he was a zookeeper over in New Jersey. He has been bitten by a Bolivian vampire gerbil. And we don't know how he's going to react to this. Wait a minute. I see him in the... He's back again. Ladies and gentlemen, Hal, what's different about you?
Put it this way. This is the second time this year I've been bitten by a Bolivian vampire hamster. And it's no joke. Put it this way. Animal safety is very important.
Hal, I mean, is this going to change your lifestyle? Don't you have to get up in the morning and be out in the sunshine and everything to do your job as zookeeper?
No, I'm not worried about that. Put it this way, I'm worried about what my mom's going to say because I live in her basement. Put it this way, I'm out of here.
What? Ladies and gentlemen, that is Mr. Hal Barris, who has turned into a vampire. Ladies and gentlemen, I was going to put the bite on him, and I didn't want to hurt his feelings, but, ladies and gentlemen, that's another segment of Eye on America, and we want to thank our guest, Mr. Hal Dracula Barris. Okay, he's changed his name now. It's Mr. Hal Dracula Barris, and he'll be appearing in a cheap movie near you. Ladies and gentlemen, that has been Mike Baldwin with Eye on America.